claps his hands, gets the snap. Looking to his left, now to his right. Now Will's got to get rid of it. Throws right side. Marks comes back to it. Makes the grab, but he was out. He dropped it. Incomplete. Excuse me. I thought he was going to get there. It looked like he'd come back, but he bobbled it and lost it along the boundary right side. Oh, my, what a play it could have been. Instead, it's incomplete, and it's second and goal, and the clock stops with 34 seconds left in the half. State still has all its timeouts. They can look at the middle of the field, too, with 27 seconds left. In the KCIH red zone, the Ole Miss 15, second and goal. Three receivers left, one right. Rogers gets a snap. Throwing for Marks, and this one's off his face mask inside the 10 and incomplete. He was all alone trying to run under it. He looked up, and when he looked up, it hit him right in the face mask.
Yeah, it was tangled up out there with the defender, and the ball had been thrown up. He was trying to get away from the tangle, and as he did, the ball's already there, and he just couldn't get his hands up to the football. And that's two times now that your running back, Marks, has had a walk-in touchdown if he could just hang on to the football.
So now it's third and goal. Clock stopped with 21 seconds left. Third down's where the magic has happened for State on this drive. And it's been Tulu Griffin with a great catch on third and 10. Could they go to him again here on third and goal from the 15? Rogers takes a snap, throwing for Griffin. He goes up and he drops it in the front of the end zone. Separated from his man, had it in his hands, and it slipped out incomplete. Fourth down.
Yeah, and you have to wonder. I mean, the only thing you can point to in a team that has had almost no drops by pass catchers over the last 4 or 5 weeks is the rain that's falling. I mean, that's the only thing that is any different here, and that is just killer. Now, if you can knock this field goal through, cut it to a one-point game, State's going to get the ball to start the second half. But that's a punch in the gut right there.
So State's
absolutely a punch in the gut.
Going to attempt its fourth field goal in this half. This will be a 33-yarder off the right hash from McCord, brought to you by Mississippi Blood Services. Snap is back. Day gets a hold down. The kick is away.
Missed it.
And he missed it right. So after Nolan McCord hit his first two, he has missed back-to-back. And Mississippi State, again, unable to finish a drive on offense with a touchdown. And with 11 seconds left, Ole Miss's lead holds at 10-6.
Well, you know, there's been so much good in the first half for State. Offensively, defensively, you know, you've only given up one touchdown drive. You've really moved the ball at times. You've gotten into scoring territory some. But